Hello guys, I'm Peter from Build a Boeing, and in this video I'd like to cover one of the first questions people ask when they are building a cockpit, and that is which monitors to use in the main instrument panel. Now if you look across here, you can see five screens. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 over there. Then you have the number 6 down here, which is the lower ICAS, which I'm missing right now, but I'll get back to that. Each of these screens, they are approximately 10.4 inches across, and so 6 of these will be around $600, as they are approximately $100 each. However, if you do a bit of research, you can find another and cheaper solution, and that is to combine these two in one monitor and combine this cluster in one monitor with two digital gauges. For that solution, you need a 19-inch monitor to cover this area here, and of course on the first officer side as well, and then you need a 15-inch monitor for this cluster. Using a 19 and a 15-inch monitor will have the advantage that they are rather cheap. Where I live, you can find used 19-inch monitors for as low as $10 or $20. 15-inch monitors are a bit more rare, but still $20, you should be able to find that. They are old, however, so you need to connect them using a VGA cable. You cannot use HDMI. But the advantage of doing this is instead of having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screens installed, I now have 3, which means I only need 3 ports on my graphic cards. So I'm also saving bucks on not having that many graphic cards in my computer. When you do this, you need to build that clock over there yourself. When you buy a cockpit, you will get a faceplate like this, and then you need to find some 7-segment displays like this with a bunch of wires, and then you need to figure out how to make a mechanical hand that can move, and with some gears and a motor, and I'm sure you can, from just the tired sound in my voice, hear that that is just one big hassle to make, and I never succeeded in making that clock. So I came up with another solution, and that is to skip the 19-inch monitor and instead use a 23-inch monitor, and that runs all the way from over here and to there. Actually, I started researching 7-inch monitors for this section for the clock, but I just ended up with one monitor going all the way across from here and all the way over there. The only downside to that is I'm not able to install the nose wheel steering switch, because I cannot fit a toggle switch. There's a monitor right behind that hole. When I installed my monitors, the old monitors, I actually put glass here between the main instrument panel and the monitor itself. So this is glass, which gives that shiny effect. And you can actually see that the glass is cracked right there. But that gives me a few millimeters, just enough space, so that over here I can fit a tact switch and some thin wires that's running behind here and then out behind the monitor. So these switches are actually working. I'm using 6 millimeter tact switches with a very long shaft like this, and then some ribbon cable like this to connect them, and that works. The only thing you should be aware of here is that this monitor here, the 23-inch monitor, it should be a wide ratio. You cannot use the standard size because that's too high. So you're gonna put it here, and if you use a standard screen, it's just gonna go too low and stick out below your panel here. So you need to find a wide ratio. And of course, that's a newer monitor, so that's gonna cost you some bucks. But just building that watch, oh, it almost killed me. So I'm very happy with this solution. Over here, I had a lower ICAS installed before, but I just bought 2 CDUs instead of 1. So the old screen I had started here, and then it ran approximately over here. And that isn't working right now, because now I have a CDU here. So I've skipped that one. And up here, this 15-inch monitor, of course, starts here, and it ends around approximately down here. So I'm not able to get a second screen
fitted here unless I buy one of those expensive 10x4 monitors. I might end up doing that, but right now I am considering an alternative and see if I can find a 14-inch monitor from an old laptop in a wide ratio again, so it isn't that high, and that will give me clearance down here so that I can slide a screen underneath here instead of buying expensive 10.4. Perhaps I can just find an old laptop screen for, let's say, $20 and fit it right there. More on that later, but if you are considering monitors for your cockpit, I think you should consider getting those 23-inch monitors for your main instrument panel, for the navigation display, primary flight display, and the clock over there. I'm Peter from Billabong. You guys take care.